React Router version 7 was released. And that's of course a big thing because React Router is arguably the most popular and most used routing library for React. And even though it's a new major version, on the one hand, it does not change that much because your existing React Router version 6, especially version 6.4 or higher code, will continue to work. But on the other hand, it is a pretty big new release, and I'll tell you why. Because with React Router version 7, we essentially, for the first time ever, have the choice whether we want to use it as a library, as a routing library, as we always did, or if you want to use it as a framework, as an alternative to Next.js, for example. With React Router version 7, you can do both. Now, let's start with the library part. Though, to be clear, it's one and the same package you install. Though if you go for the framework solution, you'll actually have to install some additional packages in addition to the React Router package. But in its core, you'll be using the React Router package either way, just with or without some extra packages. Though there is one difference already. You can now just install React Router instead of React Router DOM, which you in the past pretty much always installed. And all the APIs, all the functions, everything that makes up React Router has been baked into this one package. So you don't need both, you don't need React Router DOM, you just need React Router. Though they also published the same version essentially under the library name React Router DOM, so that you can also continue using that package like you did in the past with older React Router versions where you always had to use React Router DOM. And now you can use both, but in the future it will probably, as it seems, move towards the React Router package instead of React Router DOM. So you install React Router DOM, and if you install it into an existing project where you're already using React Router DOM, I guess, version 6 or 6.4 especially or higher, everything or almost everything should continue to work as it did before. You still set up routes and navigate around as you did before. You don't need to rewrite your code. Though there have been some changes that might need changes to your code, and there is an official upgrade guide, and the React Router team has the thing that they basically try to publish all the new things or all the changes that will happen in older versions already, so in older versions of React Router, so version 6.x, and you have to unlock them there by setting certain flags in your React Router configuration. And if you do set all these future flags, as they call them, and you then make your code changes in the older React Router versions already, once you upgrade to the newer version, everything should work. That's their thing. I'm not sure how many people really use this approach, but that is how you could have migrated to React Router 7 a couple of weeks and months ago already. Either way, even if you did not do that, you find all the changes you will have to make in that upgrade document here, in that upgrade guide. But to be honest, most of these changes are pretty niche and most likely won't affect you. So most React Router 6 code should work with React Router 7 as well. Though, funnily enough, I found two changes that are not mentioned here in this upgrade guide that did affect my code, my projects where I used React Router version 6. For example, when checking the code of my React course to make sure that it still works with React Router 7, and it does, of course, but when doing that, I found out that there were two minor adjustments I had to make, and which I did therefore already incorporate into the course, of course, which may affect your projects as well. And by the way, this React course is currently on sale since it's Black Friday, or Black Friday is around the corner to be precise. And just as this course is on sale, you can also get the Academy Pro annual membership, which gives you full access to all my courses for a great price right now as well, because we got a Black Friday sale there as well. And you find links to these offers below the video. But what are these changes I mentioned? Well, for one, the JSON utility function that was offered by React Router version 6 has been removed with that release of React Router 7. And that was a function you could use to construct JSON responses in your React Router code. So if you did use that function, you now have to construct the response object manually. And the other change is related to the defer function. And that's a function which, in my opinion, was pretty important because you could use it to defer the loading of data, essentially, so that you send a promise instead of the loaded data to your React component when using the data fetching features React Router version 6.4 introduced. And you would then render the rest of the component and not wait with rendering everything until the data is there, but instead render everything that does not need the data right away, and then just load the data and display the content that depends on the data after the rest of the component has been rendered. That was what defer helped you with. And this feature still exists with React Router version 7. It's now just easier to use because you don't need the defer wrapper function anymore. Instead, you can just directly send a promise instead of the resolved data to your component and then await it as you did before, and everything will work as before, but this extra wrapper function is not needed anymore. So that's of course a great change. I guess it just would have been nice to mention it here in the upgrade document, but now you know. And that's essentially it. That's in a nutshell what changed, or at least the changes I'm aware of, and therefore most React Router dependent apps should work right away, or should be very easy to upgrade to React Router version 7. So why do we have this new version then, if it's just essentially like the old version? Because of course, for one, we do have some breaking changes, so technically it makes sense to release a major new version, but also because now, as I mentioned initially, there is an entirely new way of using this package. You cannot just add it to your existing Vite-based or Create React app-based React app, but instead, you can also now use React Router as a framework. And to understand this, we have to take a step back and look at the history of React Router. Because, of course, React Router has been the most used and popular React routing library forever, I guess. But it was in 2020, 2021 that the React Router team started working on a React framework, basically on an alternative to Next.js. They started working on Remix. And Remix really was and is an amazing framework, in my opinion. It introduced the idea of having these loader and action functions, which you might know. And that's why the team behind Remix, which, remember, is the team behind React Router, started to bring many, I guess, of the exciting features they introduced to Remix back to React Router. And that's why we got React Router version 6.4, which also added the concept of loader and action functions to React Router. The difference to Remix essentially was that the loader and action functions in React Router, since it's a client-side library, were meant to run on the client side, whereas with Remix, they would run on the server side. With Remix, you could build full-stack React applications. With React Router version 6.4 or higher, you were still building client-side React applications, but you could outsource your data loading and your mutation code to these loader and action functions. But you would still send requests to external REST APIs there or something like that. So that's what we got with React Router 6.4. Features from Remix were added back to React Router. And consequently, Remix started using React Router under the hood. So essentially, the team, which is one and the same team as mentioned, tried to not manage two independent packages that were to a huge amount doing the same thing, but they tried to merge them or be able to use one package in the other, I guess. Well, And they continued that path. And earlier this year, and I created a video about that, they announced they wanted to bring Remix into React Router so that you have just one package, React Router, which you could either use as a routing library in a client-side React app, as you always did, or as a potentially full-stack framework. And that's what we have now with React Router 7. It's essentially Remix baked into React Router. And that's why you can use React Router version 7 in two ways. As a library, as you always did, or as a framework, as a full-stack framework if you want to. Now, if you decide to use React Router as a framework, you will typically create your project in a different way than if you would go for React Router as a routing library, or you would have to install some extra packages manually because some extra packages besides the React Router package are needed to make this framework approach work. Because when using React Router as a framework, in addition to loading components as routes, it will actually also take care of code splitting, code optimization, and also, most importantly, server rendering. If you want that, you can turn it off. But if you want it, then you can build a full stack application with React Router as a framework, and they give you all the packages you need. They give you a template you can use to start new projects to build such a React full stack application with React Router as the helping framework. And when using that framework approach with all these extra packages, you don't just have server-side rendering, but you can also define your routes differently in a dedicated file. You can also turn on file-based routing if you want to use the file system for routing so that routes are detected automatically based on your file system structure, and so on. So that's the idea with that framework approach. And if you go for that framework approach and you turn on server-side rendering, so you tell React Router that you plan to run at least parts of the code on the server, if you do that, then your loader and action functions will again just run on the server as they always did with Remix. You have these functions running on the server then, and if you still need to also fetch some data or mutate some data on the client and you want to move that code out of your components, you can use the dedicated client loader and client action functions there. That's the idea behind this framework approach. And if you've used Remix before, migrating to React Router version 7 and using that as a framework, of course, won't be too difficult because it has the same ideas, the same way of building full stack React applications in the end. It's now just all in one package. And that's, of course, pretty exciting in my opinion, because if you are not interested in Remix and React frameworks and full stack apps and all of that, you can, of course, totally ignore that framework part and you can use React Router as a library as you always did. You don't even have to upgrade to React Router 7, of course, if you don't want that. But if you are interested in building a React app with an extra framework that helps you, if you are interested maybe in building a full stack React app where parts of your code run on the server, then you now again have an interesting alternative to Next.js. You could have used Remix in the past too, of course, but now it's just one package you maybe already know that you can use to build these apps. And therefore, as I mentioned in that video earlier this year already, I think that's a pretty smart move by the Remix React Router team. And I don't think that they planned it as a strategic move. I'm not sure though. But it's a smart move in my opinion because they're publishing their framework as part of a library that gets used by millions of projects and code bases. So that, of course, makes switching to React Router as a framework relatively easy, and that, of course, can give them an edge over Next.js, for example, because you now no longer have to search for a different full stack framework. You don't have to search for a Remix. You don't have to learn a new framework. Instead, you can use your existing knowledge and switch to that framework approach relatively easily if you want to. We'll see how that will turn out. And of course, you don't have to, but I think It's an interesting release for that reason.